business users and analysts often monitor their measures as a trend over time, and with time series forecasting, they can estimate how the historical sequence of observations will continue into the future. The ability to predict how trend lines are likely to evolve can inform strategy and decision making. In Qlik Cloud, the time series forecasting option produces visualizations that extend trend lines with predicted values generated and presented on the line chart. Depending on the method employed, a shaded area representing the confidence interval displays possible values with a configurable level of confidence. Time series forecasting clearly differentiates predicted values from historical values. Singular spectrum analysis, also known as SSA, uses an algorithm that provides a confidence interval and the ordinary least squares method, also known as OLS, provides a simple linear regression line. It is important to note that the forecast toggle setting appears in the measure properties only when the measure is a numerical or time dimension and the dimension axis is continuous. In this example, using the data load editor, we load this dataset that contains two fields, date for the continuous dimension and the daily electricity usage in kilowatt hours for the measure. Once the data has been loaded, we navigate to the sheet to create a line chart with time series forecasting. From the Assets panel, drag an empty line chart onto the sheet. Select Add Dimension and add the field Date. Select Add Measure and add the measure for the average of the total kilowatt hours. In the Appearance section, expand Presentation Properties and select None for Mini Chart. When it is toggled on, the forecast time series properties will be displayed in both the Dimension and Measure panels. Use the selector to turn forecast on. Move the slider to change line thickness to 2. Change the color to green. Keep the default value for line type and line curve. Change the confidence level value from the default value of 0.95 to 0.85. Dimension properties address horizon distance and increment settings. In this case, we keep the default values so you can see the granularity of the forecast for the daily interval. You can change the interval to week to have a different forecast. In the Appearance section, expand Presentation Properties and select Show Data Points. Expand Dimension Properties and change the value for forecast steps to 21. Change the time and number unit drop-down selection to days. As you can see, the forecast is now rendered very differently because we changed the time interval. And that concludes this video. Thanks for watching!